Welcome to Truly Open Infrastructures with OCP. My name is Menno Kortekaas from CircleBee, and later Thijs from Ajima will take over for the network part. So we work with Ajima and with their mother company Delta. They are manufacturer of rack power and network infrastructure, and we provide the overall OCP-based solutions. So the solution that we provide consists of a rack with power, the server storage components, network, and also we offer services, and we have a partner for the data center part. So why do we choose to promote OCP? Because we believe that this is the next step in the evolution of the data center. If you look at traditional hardware design, you'll see that it's quite difficult to maintain. For example, if you want to replace the CMOS battery, it's layered under this component, and it takes a lot of time to replace this. And here you'll see it has Delta fans, so correct fans. But it's like you're missing some fans. Just somehow they choose to not put this fan, even though there is a network card here that's not being cooled. You'll see a lot of use of traditional connectors within the data center. This is quite an old server. It still has the PS2 ports, I believe. It has some connectors that basically nobody uses. These VGA, it's not being used anymore, but a lot of servers still have it. A lot of USB ports, again, the VGA port, and you'll see like it has redundant power supply, but this one is somehow it's not being used, might be broken. Nobody cared to replace it. I don't know, these are just some pictures I took in a data center while I was visiting there. So this is real life in Amsterdam. This is still happening. And then there's the overall complete rack, which also in many cases looks like this big mess. So this doesn't work for large-scale companies. But these large-scale companies, these web-scale companies, they know how to hack stuff. So in 2010, Facebook decided to go to Taiwan to ASUS to basically hack some hardware together. And in the spirit of what they do, they open-sourced this hardware because their motto is to always be open. So they founded the OCP Foundation in 2011 with Facebook together with Microsoft and Rackspace. And we are an open community member of the OCP Foundation. After this talk, John LeBan will also present something. He is the official representative of the OCP Foundation here in Europe. So if you want to see another presentation about OCP, just stay here. You can also get involved with OCP. There are different projects, and there is, as you can see, there's a mailing list, there's a wiki page where you can find all the designs. So it's really open. You can find all the hardware designs there. You could, I don't see that happening much, but you could like build it yourself, because that's the idea of these companies, that you have one design and there's multiple manufacturers, and you can multi-source the same design. It's a rack scale architecture. You need to begin with one whole rack and then just expand, like it's limitless. It's a modular design. As I said, the biggest module that we deliver is the rack with the power shelf, power supplies inside, then the servers, the storage. It's all serviceable from the front of the rack. You don't need to be in the hot aisle behind the rack. It's a toolless design. I also have a server here. You can see it if you want to have a look later. Just take a look. All the green points are touch points. They're at the front. And yeah, you don't need any tools for maintenance. Big fans. There's a lot of innovation. So Facebook has their own lab, and all these other contributors that open source their designs, they do a lot of innovation. It's basically what you see in software. The continuous development is also being done on hardware. It also uses green materials that you don't see in any other manufacturer. Natural fibers mixed with plastics, which makes it easier to break down, less harm for the environment. And these plastics are used in different components like hard disk carrier. So this is the Tioga Pass server, latest Intel scalable processor family. Some technical specifications. We have a rack downstairs, so if you're interested, you can see all the components there. As I just pointed out, it uses large fans and large heat sinks, which are more efficient. There's no logos, no bezels, free airflow. And this example is the first server to also use Facebook's OpenBMC, which is available on Facebook's GitHub page. And all the components use this same BMC software. So there's no, you're not dependent on like the software that the integrator provides. They have their own BMC software now. So the web scalers, how do they implement this? They think big, and they have standard rack designs, such as maybe you're familiar with server chassis. But this is basically a whole rack design with a mix of compute, storage, and power as required by the application. So this would be for analytics, Hadoop, and other type of racks, type 3 for high performance. You'll see that because of power limitations in the rack, they leave some space empty, or maybe for cooling. This is what Yahoo implemented, Yahoo Japan America. If you would want to see more of this, then there's a YouTube video. They gave a presentation at the OCP Summit. So this is from the same manufacturer as our servers, just a different mechanical design on the front of the server. They run OpenStack on this, Hadoop, Kubernetes. They've tested serviceability of the server. They demonstrate this in the video, and here it shows like how much time they need to replace a component. So the CMOS battery is the easiest because it's right in front here. The battery is just here, and then what takes the longest is replacing the mezzanine network card, because that's under like a lot of other equipment that you need to remove first. So this is also good for clouds, using automated provisioning based on standard hardware. Now, if you this is from what OpenStack always has, and a lot of vendors show this, but the standard hardware, usually it's not really standard hardware. This is real standard hardware. Once you've created a profile for a server with a certain onboard NIC or certain components on the motherboard, this will never change. It won't change from an Intel to Broadcom chip, because that's not the standard. The standard is published. There are multiple manufacturers, but the standard will be the same. It won't just suddenly change because there's a cheaper component of a different vendor. So that's why this is the ultimate open standard hardware. And using this hardware, it allows you, as with your private cloud, based on maybe this open source software, with open hardware, allows you to compete against public cloud vendors, like Rackspace, for example. One of our customers that's using this hardware with OpenStack is Arctic Circle. They're building an Arctic cloud. They like to use the innovation that these design companies such as Microsoft and Facebook bring. And for them, this is a natural choice to use this. So the Arctic Circle data center really is in the Arctic Circle. And it's quite far from the Netherlands. At the moment, they have a small deployment, but they plan to extend with a large site over there. So what we proposed for, that was the initial proposal that we did for them, is a rack with some mixed type of machines, like monitor nodes, compute nodes, routers, firewalls, and some storage nodes. So this is like a one rack mixed solution, and this is kind of the minimum that you have to start with because of the 21-inch OCP standard that we promote. You always need to start with a rack as a sort of a chassis and with the central power shelf. So they have already finished testing their OCP rack and decided to go for OCP. They're now building an A and B site and a backup site. And they're onboarding customers on this proof of concept. In the Netherlands, we also have an OCP white space available. Because of the size of the rack and the weight, and the rack, normally it comes completely filled with equipment. That's how we assemble it. So you need to, your data center needs to be able to handle this complete rack. We can help with that, or we can offer OCP ready space. So we're here to help as Circle B. You're not alone. We have some social media, Twitter, Facebook, and a lot of YouTube videos, explainer videos, and recordings of previous sessions you can find on our YouTube channel, or just go to our website. And also still looking for subscribers to make this link become a short one. I will now hand over the microphone to Thijs, who will tell more about open networking. If after this, if you want to see the server, then feel free to come forward or visit our booth.
Thank you. So my name is Thijs van Nesveld. I work for Delta Electronics and specifically focus on the Agema brand network switches. We are what we call white box switches, or doing open networking. So as Menno explained, how you go to the process of how you select your OCP hardware, it's quite similar in the white box or bare metal switching. And basically you can make three choices in the process. So we have the silicon that's based for the switching fabric, the manufacturer that builds the switch eventually, and an operating system that runs on your hardware. And all of this is standard based, and it removed the vendor lock-in that has been going into the industry for many years before. While Menno was talking about 21-inch hardware, in the networking world, you still see that the standard stays at 19-inch. The reason for this is that even the hyperscalers, they are not only using the hardware in their specific data centers that they build themselves and design themselves, but also use a lot of other locations for their network equipment. And usually these are the known standard data centers around the world. So they need the 19-inch standard for this. This is an example of the very first open networking switch designed by Facebook. It's the Wedge 40. They built it based on the Broadcom Trident 2 chipset. They sourced a lot of components from different manufacturers. I think this one was built by... is it Wistron or Acton? Acton, sorry. And well, they expanded this portfolio after quite rapidly. Yeah, it's a very standard design, so it's not really exciting, but this was the first one that was fully open sourced in all the design and all the components. So in the choice of silicon, for myself, I work only with Broadcom at the moment, but of course there are other choices. So for Broadcom, as in the Wedge 40, you can choose, for example, a Trident 2 chipset, and you can use this in different configuration, for example, 32-port 40G ports. But we also supply a similar switch with 10G ports and 40G uplink. Tomahawk, which enables to go up to 100 gigabit. And it will enable some other features in hardware like VXLAN. So the performance is simply better. And as Delta, we are also focusing a lot on the Broadcom DNX chipset. And in this family, you find Qumran and Jericho. These chipsets are all rated from 10, 25 up to 100G. But they have a larger feature set in the chip, and they support, for example, a packet buffer for the Jericho Plus model that I have downstairs as a prototype. For example, it will have 16 gigabyte packet buffer, and it can filter out microbursts, for example, in the network. And also extended TCAM support for large routing tables. In Jericho, it will support approximately 2 million routes in a 1U box. Simple chassis. Like Menno already told, I mean, it's all about standardization. So, for example, a Trident 2 chip, you see it being used in a lot of different boxes with different forms of openness. But it's simply cheaper to use the same chip than design your own chip. And if the performance is good or good enough, why not use it? So our focus is mainly on data center and carrier networks. We are an OCP Platinum member, and it means that all the designs that we have, we will open source into the Open Compute Wiki. And this is an ongoing process, so at the moment, not all of our designs are there yet, but in general, you can assume that every hardware we have, we will upload the specifications and give them to the community. Some specifications for a Jericho platform, for example. In this kind of documents, you will find a full overview of the hardware specification, but also information about addressing of chips, etc. This also helps for software development, of course, when they want to develop their own software or use available software like Cumulus or IP Infusion or Broadcom ICOS. I'm not going through all the specification. If you're really interested in this kind of thing, just come by the booth and we can talk about it. So every switch is supplied with an open network installer environment, which is initially developed by Cumulus. This is basically the standard for open networking in the OCP project. It's a small bootloader in helping to install operating system on the switch. Depending on the manufacturer, you will have more or less different kind of operating systems available for the platform. We are working with Cumulus, And but we're still waiting for the release on that. We are working with IP Infusion for software which is readily available. We also work with Broadcom software that's also readily available from us on most of our platforms. So in the whole, where is this in the whole OpenStack picture? As Ajima, we supply the hardware and we help with the operating system. We work a lot together with Menno. He can also help on the integration of the other part, hardware parts. And on top of that, of course, you have your software, which is basically the customer's own domain, or if they use an integrator or a consultancy, they will help with that part. It's not in our knowledge to help on these parts ourselves, and we do not have the resources for that. The ONI installer is it's very simple. So this is one of our switches. It's currently already running IP Infusion OCnos, but in case you would like to change to a different operating system during the boot process, you can simply go into ONI, and you have options here to either install the OS. For example, in IP Infusion, you can simply update the software by reinstalling, and it will detect automatically that there's an older version. If you want to install new software, you uninstall the old one, reboot the switch, come back into ONI mode, install the operating system, and you're running. And this can be enhanced with zero-touch provisioning by setting up your own server infrastructure to support this as well. So this is an example of a simple cloth fabric for a small implementation. And the advantage of this is that it scales very easily. So this is a small implementation, but at scale, you can use the same hardware and go to a much larger implementation. And even in a large project like this, you will have a lot of equal performance part through the network. So no matter where your network disruption is, you will always have a good path into the network, and this makes it very very reliable. Okay, well, this was my part of the presentation. So if anyone have questions about Menno's part or my part, please let us know.
We have a few minutes, 4 minutes left.
Perfect.
If there are any questions.
Could you tell them how inexpensive this open source hardware is?
Hardware inexpensive?
Yeah. Because it's all technology, but compared to the big brand switches. By the way, the big brand switch manufacturers that you know about don't make the stuff. And all the big brand switch manufacturers do is just basically lock you in with proprietary operating systems. But the difference in price is huge.
Yeah, we have no vendor lock-in on the switches for SFP modules, for example. So that's where you can win a lot. And there's a lot of components with the servers, there's a lot of components left out. So we have a central power shelf with 6 power supplies instead of, like, if you have 30 servers, you'll probably have 50 power supplies now. Depending on how much kilowattage you need, it can be 6 or even 3, or you can also add some power supplies. There's also no like central PDU that you might have to switch servers on and off and measure power usage. It's not needed with this rack. There are many more components that can be left out. I saw there was a
Yeah, so you're getting some experience now with deploying this. So what is the main hurdle of getting this, you know, adopted in the industry? Maybe there's more to this.
I think, yeah, from my side, if specifically on networking, it's, for example, people are, they have a vendor certification. So they only feel comfortable with this certain vendor. But the CLI of one of our software suppliers, it looks exactly like, let's say, industry standard CLI. But there's still a hurdle. So that's one of the, like, I think we need to train ourselves on standards instead of on vendors. I think that's where we need to move towards. But that's one of the hurdles.
Yeah, another thing I think for hurdles is that a lot of companies are afraid to take back the control into their own domain and getting the knowledge in-house. So a lot of companies have been pushing out as much knowledge as possible, saying, okay, you're my network supplier, you do everything for my network. If something breaks, I will point at you, you will solve it, or you will...
But I guess you have a support model around that, because...
Yeah,
we work now on a deployment next week with Fairbanks, where we do the whole solution basically. So it's the servers network with OpenStack fully supported and integrated. So it's possible, it's available, it can be done today.
Yeah. How many different vendors are there for the servers?
So for this server, there are two manufacturers, and we work with Wiwi, and there's another one, QCT, and they make the same design. They build this at large scale. But for networking, there are many more different networking designers.
Yeah, for networking, you have Acton, you have Delta.
Celestica, Mellanox. And on the software part as well, there's a lot of availability depending on which features you need, if you're more into routing or more into switching within the data center.
Yeah.
But that's why we are here to help to provide you the information so that you can choose wisely based on your needs.